Hey guys, in this video we'll see how to use Mockito in Flutter. Let's launch our app and see what's inside it. So it loads for some time. So this is our home screen, and we scroll at the bottom, we see there are two buttons. We click on the first button, so this leads to our second screen, which has some content in it, and let's press back. We click on the second button now. It loads for some time and shows the data. So this is our third screen. If we click on any tile, it would launch a URL associated with it. So for example, the second tile has Google in it. Let's press back and we come to the home screen. For the app, we are using the MVVM plus repository pattern. So each screen has a repository associated with it. And each repository talks with the view model. A view model is basically a glue between the view and the repository. So view model in turn talks to the view, and the view talks to the model. So basically, model is simply the casting of your response from the repository into something which view would be consuming. So all those manipulation is handled by that view model. From the app side, it looks like this. So we have a home folder and a second screen folder called as Fringilla and a third screen folder called as Pelin. Expanding the home folder, we see that we have repository, we have a view model, we have a view, and then there is a model associated with this home. All this folder pattern will have the same structure. So for example, let me take Pelin. It would have a repository, it would have a view model, it would have a view, and it would have a model. For installing Mockito, we head over to pub.dev, we search for Mockito, and find its correct dependency version. Inside our pubspec YAML, we add the Mockito dependency, and also we need another dependency called as build runner, which will be used to generate the mock classes. Let's head over to our test folder, and here we create subfolders based on our screens, for example, home and Fringilla. So let's look inside the home folder now. So there is a repository test called as home repo test. There is a mock generated class by Mockito. And then finally, we have a view model test. So this is how our home repo test looks like. Firstly, we create a class which extends mock and implements our home repo. So for mocking any repository, we need to create a class which has to extend mock. And this mock comes from package Mockito. So before deep diving into the test, let's look into what's inside our home repo. This is how our home repo class looks like. So we have one method definition called as fetch data. And inside the home repo implementation, we define that method in which we create a delay of 1800 milliseconds. And finally, we load the data from the JSON file itself. Back in our home repo test, we use annotation by Mockito called @generateMocks, and inside it we specify the mock class name which we want to generate the code for. So in our case, we specify it to be home repo test, and this annotation should be used before the entry point of our test, which is main for any dart file. After specifying the generate mocks annotation, we build the mock class using this command and press enter. After some time, the build runner finishes generating the classes, and the class which generated was this home repo test.mocks. This is how our mock generated class looks like, where this has its own prefixes for imports. But at the main or the crux of this file is this function fetch data. Now we compare the original home repo and the mock generated home repo. So in the bottom, we see the fetch data here. And inside our home repo, we have that same function called as fetchData. Inside our mock function fetchData, it's using the invocation method, and the method name is the same which is in our abstract class. And the return value from this mock class is basically the carousel model, which is the same we get from our abstract class fetchData. Coming back to our home repo test, we specify the home repo, and inside the setup all, we initialize this since we have our mock home repo ready. And this can only be extended if you import that file itself. So next, let's see how we have written the unit tests. We have two tests for our repository. The first one is testing the fetch data, in which we basically stub the response from the fetch data from which is exposed by that home repository using Mockito stubbing, and specifically using the when and then answer. As per the official documentation, when is basically creating a stub method response, and this then answer is basically storing a function which is called when this method stub is called. Inside this then answer block, we return the model, which is simply but our carousel model. Once the stubbing is done, we now call the home repository's fetch data, and we have two expectations here. The first one, we want the result to be matching against a type carousel model. This type matching is achieved using isA, which is basically returning a matcher that matches objects with some type. And inside our next expectation, we want the result to be equal to the model. And since we had already stubbed the response previously, we will be having this. Inside our second test case, we check the fetch data against exception. We use the Mockito stubbing again using when. We call the fetch data, but in the then answer block, instead of returning some response or model, we are throwing an exception. Now we call the home repository's fetch data again, but this time we expect the result to be of type throws exception. And if we look at the documentation, it is basically a matcher for functions that throw exceptions. Let's run our test now by using the Flutter test command, and we are specifically running the home repo test. So let's click enter. We see here that all tests are passed. Let's see now how to test our home view model test. But before that, we need to see how does our home view model look like. This is how our home view model looks like. So the constructor takes in a required parameter of home repository. And inside this view model, we have one function called as fetch data. And this basically calls the repository's fetch data. And if we recall correctly, this fetch data is nothing but we create a delay of 1800 milliseconds and we get our JSON file. So once we get the response, we create our setter and we set that model, which is carousel model, inside our view model. Coming back to our home view model test, we mention the two parameters or two dependencies which we require. The first one is mock home repo test, which is the same file we generated using Mockito. And the other one is the home view model itself. And as we just saw, our home view model takes in a required parameter of our repository, which in this case is our mock home repo. Let's look at our tests which we wrote for this view model. There are two tests for this view model. In the first test, we call the fetch data. So basically, we use the Mockito stubbing for creating or for calling the home repository's fetch data. And in the then answer, we return the stub response, which is a carousel model. Next, we call in the view model's fetch data. And in the final part, we expect the home model to be equal to the model, which is our stub response. So since inside our view model fetch data, the response which we get from the repository's fetch data is set to the home model. So this expectation would be passed. In the second test, we test for the fetch data in the repository. We again use the Mockito stubbing. We call the repository's fetch data, and in the then answer, we stub it to carousel model. Next, we call in the repository's fetch data. Note that in the previous test case, we were calling viewmodel's fetch data, but here we are calling the repository's fetch data. Now, since we are calling repository's fetch data, we need to set the viewmodel's data equal to the response, which is done in the line 38. And finally, once it's done, we can expect the home model, which is inside the view model, to be equal to the stub response. Let's now try running the home view model test. So we click enter and we see all our tests are passed. For code coverage in VS Code, we need to install two plugins. So head over to the plugin section here and install coverage gutters as well as Flutter coverage. Next, we need to run this command, which is flutter test dash dash coverage. After running this, this generates a lcov.info file inside our app itself. As we see here, it says all tests are passed. And if we see in the left hand side section, we see a coverage folder containing lcov.info file. So this is basically which will help us in getting our code coverage. Checking the code coverage, head over to the left hand side section again, click on this testing icon, and we see here Flutter coverage, which is something new coming out of that plugin itself. And we see our home view model, which was the test we wrote for, and the percentage is displayed as 90.9 here. Inside the Android Studio, just navigate to your test and right click on your group of tests and run like home view model test with coverage. That's it from this video, guys. If you like this video, share, subscribe, and comment.